ladies and gentlemen. Today we're taking a look at a 1919 Aultman Taylor tractor. This tractor is 22 horsepower on the drawbar, meaning it's capable of pulling 22 horsepower, and 45 horsepower on the belt pulley here, which is what you'd use to power thrashing machines, sawmills, whatever you need belt driven at that time period. Taking a look at some of the unique things about this tractor, it was actually produced by the Aultman Taylor Company, which was in Mansfield, Ohio. This tractor, just some of the specs on it, weighs just under 13,000 pounds. So it's a rather large tractor, a little bit hard to maneuver. If we take a look at just some of the features on this tractor, we know it's under here, we see a lot of chains. Tractors back in that time period had a chain-driven steering system. So we have a worm gear right here, which is connected to our steering wheel up there. As we turn, it pulls and pushes on these chains, or more or less pulls on one chain versus the other to steer it. So this tractor does not turn on a dime, or a quarter for that matter. This has a 15-foot turning radius, which is rather large, so you need a lot of space to maneuver these tractors around. Just looking at some of the other interesting things about this tractor, we notice right up front we have this large barrel. If we kind of just take a look at that, we wonder what that's for. This is actually the radiator system for this tractor. Inside this barrel, you'll see there's lots of tubes that sort of flow that allow air to pass through to kind of suck away some of that heat from that engine. And that's done with this fan here that sort of pulls air throughout this radiator. And that water then gets circulated throughout this tractor system. This tractor is a four-cylinder tractor that traditionally ran on kerosene. Kerosene to burn effectively, the engine that is being burnt in must be warmed up. It's really hard to get kerosene to burn effectively on a cold engine. So what farmers would do is they would purchase gasoline to start their tractor. They would let their tractor run for a few minutes till that engine got good and warm, and then they would switch the fuel over and start burning kerosene. So if we take a look around this tractor, this has a full contractor canopy, which covers both not only the cab where the farmer or operator would be standing or sitting, but also the engine as well, keep it sort of out of the elements to the best of its abilities. These wheels, these rear wheels, are about 6 feet tall. The total height of this tractor is a little over 10 and a half feet tall, so it takes up a lot of area, which is kind of unique in that sense. This is a gear-driven tractor, so we have our engine. Everything gets transmitted through gears and comes right back to this main big bull gear back here, which is what actually propels your tractor forward and reverse. It has two speeds, a high and a low speed forward, and one speed reverse. The top speed of this tractor is just under 3 miles an hour. So it moves, but not at a quick pace by any means. And in doing that, in order to move this tractor, it actually consumes about 50% of the horsepower that it creates. So that engine is capable of producing about 45 horsepower, and it uses up a little over 22 in order to just move itself. So that's why it has two different horsepower ratings, a 22 horsepower on the drawbar, 45 on the belt pulley, because depending on what your applications were for this tractor would determine what exactly horsepower rating you were looking for as a farmer when making a purchase.